Hello. This video is a continuation of creating a frequency table and now creating a histogram and an Ogive from the table we made in the last video. So it's meant for elementary statistics students towards the beginning of the course. So in the last video, we created this table that I have right here. I have everything filled in, all of the columns of our frequency table, and this represented the ages of 20 randomly selected statistics students. So in the last video, we went through all the steps of creating this. Now we're going to go through two different, the most common types of graphs that we do from these tables are a histogram, meaning a bar graph, and an ogive. An ogive might be the one that's brand new to you. Okay, so we'll go through how to create one, what should be the labels for each one, and what each one shows you. Okay, they both show very different things. So we're going to start with the histogram, okay, the bar graph. So all these graphs are going to look like L-shaped graphs. Okay, so I'm going to put a little, I'll explain what this is in a second. Okay, so on a histogram, the two things that are graphed, okay, one is, down here is going to be the ages. And what we're going to use on this is midpoints. Okay, the reason I have this over here, right there, this just means that I have a break in my graph. It means I'm not going to have all the tick marks from 0 to 19, because that would be wasted space. So it means I'm going to start my midpoints right over here. I have a break in my graph. You can just use that where if your data doesn't really start at 0, that's a good thing to do. I'm not actually going to do it on my my y-axis, because my y-axis does only go from, 0 to 10. Okay, so let me just put, there's 1, 2. Okay, so this will be our 10. Okay, so on my y-axis for any histogram is going to be my frequency. Okay, so over here, look at the x-axis again. I have my ages, midpoints. Okay, there's more than one thing you can put on your x-axis for a histogram. I could put my ages, so let me just put over here. So my x-axis, I have two options. I could put the midpoints, or I could put the class boundaries. Okay, the one thing I can't put is my class limits. If I put my class limits, my actual bars would not be touching. In histogram, one bar is supposed to end where the other one begins. Okay, so we accomplish that by using either the midpoints or the class boundaries. So no class limits. Okay, so let's go over here. So I choose to always use midpoints. Okay, so for my first class, my midpoint is a 21.5. My next class is a 27.5. Then I have a 33.5, a 39.5, and a 45.5. Okay, so there's my midpoints. And then I'm going to the y-axis is my frequency, so I do my corresponding frequency. So a midpoint of 21.5, that first class, has a frequency of 10. So this is my midpoint, so I make my bar around that, all the way up to 10, and I have it centered there. And a lot of times I like to just put how many are in that class. Okay, 27.5, that class corresponds to 2. Okay, so this one picks up right where the other one leaves off, so there's no gap, and it's centered around the midpoint. My next class, 33.5, goes up to 6. So let me just fill this in. This was a 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 would be about up here, centered around the midpoint. And then my next one is going to be over at 1. And my last one is also over at 1. So once we have this graph completed, we see the shape of it. This particular graph, later on in the course you're going to learn about what's called a normal curve, or a right skewed or a left skewed. This graph is definitely not considered normal. It doesn't have the normal bell shape. We've got you know, a very large number of people, half of the sample, you know, between the ages of 19 and 24. We can also see that there are very few people over the age of 37 in the class. Together, those two classes only have two people out of the sample. So you can get you can see a lot about the distribution by looking at a histogram. Okay, so I'm going to change slides. Our next graph, we're going to use the same data, but we're going to create what's called an ogive. Cumulative frequency is always going up because it's always adding that class and the next and the ones before it. So my boundaries, my upper class boundaries, I'm sorry. So 24.5 is my first one. This was our bar graph. This is the graph that most people are used to making many times. The only thing you have to be careful of is what you're labeling the x-axis with. I chose midpoints, but remember we could use midpoints or we could use class boundaries. Okay, this 21.5, if you kind of think about, I'm just going to label it. I could have also labeled this with 18.5 and 24.5. It would have been this, having 21.5 in the middle or labeling the outsides is really the same thing. But what we don't want to do is we don't want to use just the class limits because then our bars would have a space. Okay, so let me just move this up a little bit. All right, I'm probably going to have to flip back and forth a little bit to get our data. But just in general, what an ogive does, it's still going to be an L-shaped graph. I'm still actually going to use my break in my axis. Okay, so the ogive on the x-axis is always going to have, it's going to be my ages again, but I'm going to use my class boundaries. This one doesn't have a choice. And actually, I'm going to add a very important word in there, upper class boundaries. Okay, so I can't use midpoints, I can't use class limits. This one I have to use the upper class boundaries. And the difference in ogive, is not a bar graph, it's a line graph. And what it graphs on the y-axis is that cumulative frequency. Okay, so this graph, if you think about cumulative frequency, let me skip, should always be increasing. It's a line graph that's always going to be increasing. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to put on my x-axis, I'm going to put my upper class limits. So let me just go back. Okay, so 24.5. I'm leaving a space, and I'm going to show you why in a second. So that's my first upper class boundary. Then my next one is 30.5. My next one is a 36.5. And then I have a 42.5 and a 48.5. Okay, so, and let me put my tick marks here. So we're going to count by twos here. 2, 4, because I have to go up to 26, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. Okay, so 24.5, I'm doing the cumulative frequency. So that one had a cumulative frequency of 10, and that was the first one. Okay, so then I'm just put this as a point. This is going to be a line graph. 30.5 had a cumulative frequency of 12. So that's going to go up to here. 36.5, when we added in that next one, had a cumulative frequency of 18. 42.5 had a cumulative frequency of 19, so up a little bit more. And then the last one should end at 20. Okay. I left a little space here because a ogive is always supposed to actually start on the x-axis. So consider we go back, 24.5, go back, imagine the upper class boundary. If we had one class before that, it would actually be that 18.5. It would be the same as the lower class boundary for that class. And so at that point, that's where we would have zero pieces of data. Okay, so it should always start on the x-axis. So now this should always be increasing. So if we connect our line graph, that's what an ogive looks like. It always increases. So it's always increasing. It ends at n. Okay, it ends at 20. And it's a line graph. Okay. The things you look at for an ogive is you can see where the biggest increase in frequency is. And that's obviously in the first class. In the first class, you go from 0 to 10. After that, you increase by 2, then by 6. After that, this class right here would also have the highest. These two right here are the highest increase in frequency. After that, we're only increasing 2 or 1 or 1. So that's what you do for an ogive. Just to kind of recap, on the x-axis, you have your ages again, but it has to be your upper class boundaries. Okay, so you put your 6 in there, your 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. Sorry, this had 5 classes. You put your 5 in there, and then you backtrack one class, okay, to get to that 18.5. I always kind of do that right at the end. And then you connect your dots, and that makes your line graph, which was where this one's called an ogive because it's your cumulative frequency. And that's it. So just again, with our upper class limits and our cumulative frequency. Thank you.